form, figure, and abstraction. Most of my work falls under literal or representational art, which is taking the world around us and putting that into my art in some way, shape, or form. A lot of artists work like this, to photograph or in some way represent the world around us as we know it. But what if we take away the world as we know it and replace that with abstract forms and figures? This is a great way to allow an audience to connect on a different level to our art, and it's a great way for us to explore how far we can take the human figure or any other figure so that we can abstract it and see it from a different perspective. My name is Brooke Shaden. I'm a fine art photographer, educator, and writer, and I would love for you to take a look at all the things that I have to offer. I've linked them below. I have classes, I sell prints, I have tons and tons of writing online, so if you want to check that out, that'd be awesome. Feel free to subscribe, and if you like the topic of this video, give this video a like. If by the end of it you don't like this video, feel free to undo that like, but thank you so much for being here. I'm so appreciative of you and this community, and let's dive in. It's not every day that I make a video featuring a trash bag and a pair of pantyhose, but today felt like the right kind of day for that, so that's what we're gonna do. I'm going to show you how I can use simple, everyday objects that you might find around the house to create some abstract figure and form work. The way that we're going to do that is to take objects like this and put them over my body and sort of stretch through them to create abstract forms. Be careful when trying this at home. Something like that. I actually have several options here today. So not only do I have the trash bag and the pantyhose, I also have some stretchy fabric, which is just some generic fabric that I found at a fabric store, nothing special. I have a dress that just happens to be stretchy. So I thought that I would bring the dress to see if we could do anything fun with that. And finally, I have a bedsheet. And if you also have a bedsheet, which I assume that you do, you can get it wet to create that clinging effect to skin. And that way you're going to create that same look as if it were stretchy fabric. So grab whatever you have at your house to shoot along with me. Remember, you don't have to have a big space to shoot. You don't have to have a lot of gear. I'm shooting with my blank wall and a window, and that's about it. So take whatever you can to create with. Join me for this photo shoot. Let's go one by one through every single thing that I have here to shoot with, which is currently laid out on my floor, and see the different results and how they turn out. We'll start with the plastic bag, since that seems like maybe one of the most accessible ones that everybody will have. So we can start there. Now I'm gonna try the dress to see how well that works. It's not super stretchy. I don't feel terribly inspired by this one, but it can't hurt to try. Next up, we have the fabric, which I like because it's a little bit see-through and has some give to it. So let's see how this goes. I now personally regret that it is time to stuff myself into a stocking. Why? Not fun, but still worth it. I'm dizzy. Okay, the last one is the bedsheet soaked in water. So I'm gonna go soak the bedsheet in water, then bring it back in. Okay, I've got just a portion of my sheet all wet, just the corner, because I think that's all I'll need. So I'm gonna put this over my head and see if I can get it to cling to my body. Cold. And I had a choice. I could have made it warm. Thank you for watching this White Wall Wednesday. And if you would like to participate, please use the hashtag White Wall Wednesday Portraits if you share an image online, or just post it in the comments below, because I would love, love, love to see what you create. I hope this was helpful for you. And if you have any tips and tricks of your own in terms of creating abstract, really sort of figure and form centered art, I would love to hear that. Any inspirations you have in that regard, let me know. Thank you for being here. Have a great White Wall Wednesday.